Now, this is not my first game. I've played it a few times over. One of the ways you could tell is by my robe, the intricate design on it. When you first start playing, it's only a first pattern all the way at the bottom of the robe, but as you continue to play through and beat the game multiple times, you unlock a more decorative robe. And I think the not no, I think I know the last robe is actually the white robe, the one that you will see on some of the beings that I come across in this game. But if you follow me or watched a few of my streams of this game, you've already know that it's a little weird, the game. Not weird, but in a bad way, but like weird in a great way, where it's putting a lot of idealistic opinions and feelings at you. Even as you play the game, it might pull out feelings out of you pertaining to some of the obstacles you go through in life. One of the main ones I've really noticed, especially in this game, is the impending fact of being alone and doing things on your own, or running into people and either assisting on the way or not assisting. You can't actually speak to a person, but you can use something like a beacon. I'll show you right now, and people will know that you're around, because you'll see like a flash of light in the corner of your screen in the direction they're going. Now, I've come to realize that these things here are actually grave sites. Of who? I know, but we'll find out as we go through the game. Okay. You can see, there's no real jumping, at least not yet. So every time I pick up one of those, I guess you can say, special points, it increases my scarf, which these little floating pieces of talisman, if you ask me, and they look like talisman. When they come to me and light my scarf up, I have the ability to float, levitate. And every time I don't have any, or if I use this, they'll come and regenerate or push me up. So you have limited flight capability, but you use it to, to your discretion. And as you go through this game as well, you should find other ones. So we are gonna look around and make sure we find them so we can increase our scarf length. I've noticed when playing a game, it's kind of funny, because there's things that you can do. And again, you can't communicate with somebody, but if you find something out that helps and you try to show them how to do it, or there's a chance that they might not pick it up. It's kind of in life, right? You try to help people and or give advice on how to do something or anything like that, and either they'll go with it or not, make it easier or make it harder. There's many situations I've played where the other person that was with me didn't follow something I was trying to show them that actually helps out, and it made the map a little harder. But I made it through. And I'll show you what that is. Yeah. So when you play some with someone and they're doing this, you can assist and you can do this together and make it easier. All right. So this right here, when you come up on these, this board, you see like the little statues in front of it. They look like the graves as well. If you do your beacon, it'll open up a picture here. And this is exactly how I figured out the first time that those markers out there were graves, because look at this. This looked like a bunch of the people like me probably died. You notice the symbols are different, right? I still don't know what they mean, but you use them a lot in the game. You can also tell that the ones that passed, their robes do look different from mine's, right? Okay, just keep that in mind. This game is very peaceful. I find myself wanting to play it in the morning at times, especially when waking up. I don't think playing Call of Duty and all that kind of violence and stuff is that productive sometimes, or at least mentally, you know. I didn't use my flight capability, I probably could have jumped up and got that, but we'll get it another way. There's no time limit on this game, so there's no need to rush through it. Now, when you do beat the games, the game, you do have an option to go to the stages that you already beat and do them over again, which I will show you after we get past the part that we were just doing here in this area. You see those glowing circles on the ground? Those represent like portals to the areas I already beat. So if I'm trying to accomplish something, maybe find everything in one area, that can assist me. Oh, let's not forget. Look, I almost forgot. Now you can either hold the X button to fly like that, or tap it. Just knowing when you hold it, you'll use up all of the flight capability immediately. But if you tap it, it'll only use one section of it. Look at that statue. Doesn't it look like someone like me? I don't know about anybody else. That looks like the creation story to me. It seems like that mountain, it's probably like, let's say like in mythology, you know, Mount Olympus, so say. And those are the gods. It seems like they put their divine spirit down and made life upon the planet and the area, you know, and the birds, and then showed that the plants, then the beings were born. And then it looked like they discovered something, because it was came out of the ground, it was glowing, kind of like some symbols that were coming from the mountain. And it looked like the rug was coming up and then those papers, so I'm guessing they found this technology, so to say, of the scarves and the talisman, and the flight capabilities. But just like the Mayan and Aztec ruins, and what happened here. I see a few. See that right there. I know there's another one here. Let's go down this floor. Can't fly. Thank you very much. Look at this. This looks like the scarf that was in that paper, that picture as well, right? And also the talisman. When I do that, look at it. Okay, releases something. creating the bridge. So now we see what we have to do. Yeah, the times I've played this game, I don't know about anybody else, but you can find yourself in thought, thinking about life, literally. This is a really peaceful game. It's like, this end is amazing. Graphics are really beautiful. They're soft. Like a softer version of Minecraft. These things laying on the ground, look at them. Look at the face on the creature. It looks like a snake. And I'm opening them up. Even act directed to sand. Now that's beautiful. Now there will be times that you'll come across areas and those little special markers are all the way in a cut. You have to get to them somehow, and it can be difficult, but there is a way, trust me. As they say, if there is a will, there is a way. It's easier. Yeah. It's like I'm catching a rod on the wind. The sand. The wind is pushing the sand and it's helping me as well. Kind of like I'm using nature and a little help from divine technology. But again, look at this thing here. This looks like a snake. Look, it got a face and everything on it. Look at that. exploring sometimes. Most of the times I like games like that. You know I'm going back there to see... Oh, look at that. See one of the mural spots on the wall in the cave back there. I'm gonna check that out. Need to recharge real quick. Thank you. Oh, found another specialty marker. Let's just say nope, I guess. Nice. Let's see what this picture has. Ah. So I'm assuming that this used to be the city that was here, that's now in ruin. Okay, we also saw that marker up there, so I'm definitely gonna go for that. Thank you for the ride. See, they could push you up, but you don't even have to use your flight to do it at first. But I usually use them and then use my flight to help me out. But look, that bridge is not complete yet, so still got something else to do here. So now, this would be a nice example. We're going to look at this again. Look at this. Look at that. Level. Look at the face on this thing. It has eyes. Alright, let's move on. I think we found everything here. Rugs. They also refill your flight scarf. You gotta light all of these up here. To activate this. These statues really do look like a version of myself. Maybe they're the elders telling us a story. As you can see, giving me the vision. This guy's all white. That must be the god. Let's continue the story. They started constructing buildings and used that technology to, okay, to make roads and technology, hell yeah. Made their buildings light up. They're on a new era. It's beautiful. So yeah, I got out of that. These beings, they of course used that technology, learned how to use it more efficiently, and created look like things with the buildings, helped them create buildings and place to live and other beauties as those large towers with the lights in it, maybe the roads and everything. Basically what we're using it for now, kinda. But I think a little more advanced than just the scarf they used for flight. And transportation. I just think that's beautiful. Look at that. At the beginning of the game, before, as you're starting, this is something you see as well. You'll see one of those flying across the sky, coming from the mountain. Another one out here. They must have created some really nice things. Beautiful pieces of machinery with this technology. Look at this. A flying carpet. And it talks like us. It seems like a pet. It's guiding me. Thank you. Okay. What is he leading me to? Now look at the creature. It does look like a full creature now. And these looks like wings. Look at that. Goodness. This might have been something it created as well. Thank you for the lift. He came and just picked me up. He or she. And they were one with Earth, maybe. That's why it looks like that. They lived out here in the desert. What was that? Did y'all see that? Oh. We have a guest. Now, looking at this guy, his scarf is longer than mine, I believe. So there must have been things I haven't found yet. Now, as you see, when we're together, it increases our flight scarf. We get the power. Also, when you're in that bubble with the other person, it gives them the ability to fly as well. So now, this is what I was talking about earlier about people working together. Now, if we fly and hit this together, and we're together, we will continuously float without problem. Now, I'm wondering if you know that, but he went down kind of low. It looked like he was doing it at the same time. He knows. He, she knows. They know what they're doing. Get that? I ran out.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to the feeling.
That was nice. Let's go. Oh. And they led us to this area, which looks crazy. Okay. Slow down, brother. Try that again. Wind is pushing us back profusely. Ah, look at that. Ah, shoot. Got it. How long his scarf is. Keep saying he. Some boost too, brother. And in life, we can help each other get past obstacles. Like that one. Maybe take shortcuts. Alright. But it looks like we missed something. I know we did, because there are some of these special markers around. That's what it looks like he's going to now. Look at that. Like I told you again, helping each other out, right? It looks like he's been through the game before as well. Scarf is a bit longer than mine. But my rogue is a lot more decorative than his, so that means I beat it more times than he did. He or she, let me say that again. Another story, grandfather? Structures over the plants. Seem like they went through a technological revolution. So it's kind of like they became their own gods. Yep. I like these little magic carpets. Look at them. Now for an adventure. Either I can stay with him, her, and help each other out, or I can just go on my own. It's easy to lose someone in this game, I've noticed. Again, he can't really talk. It looked like he just messed up. And there's a chance that I won't see him in this next stage. Oh, he made it. He saw him up there. Oh, that's funny. Now, there's a part here on this board. I've passed by it so many times, so I've slowed down. I've actually found it. Let me see if I can find it again, because there's another special marker to increase the length of my scarf. I just need to find it. I remember being up here somewhere, so we're gonna go right here. Oh, look, found it. Gotcha, bro. Slow down. There we go. There we go. Boom. It's beautiful. Look, there's a marker right there. Nice. Opening stage up really fast. I don't mind doing that, but I know there's something here. I'm not just trying to beat the game fast. Sometimes there's other things. And this might be one of the places as well, because I've come through here, but I've looked around. I knew that marker was up there, but there's something else here. And I know that. What did he do? This guy. I found one. There we go. It's more like, yeah, there we go. Sorry I couldn't help him. That was the first time I've ever come across that. The magic carpet helped me. But look how long my scarf is now. Their city. That's what they created. That's freaking beautiful. Still under the eyes of the beholder, I guess you can say. Their god. Okay, grandfather, we will listen. Do you see how long that scarf is? Let's see what happens here. Look like they lost the power. Oh, I couldn't share. Oh, those look really familiar. They started going to war with each other. They couldn't share the power. Story sound real familiar. The further and further I go into it. so let's explore a little more. I don't know what that person is doing, but I'm gonna keep going forward. Myself. It's all right. I'm gonna get through this. It's really dark down here. These are the ways to help them travel faster. I didn't want to do all that. I'm coming. It looks like I'm in water. We're not in water. It's just that I feel that this technology, this gift here, these things float like this. Like they're blowing in the wind. They look like seaweed. Someone is hailing me. Remember I said about that white white flash on the side of your screen? Someone was back there. But look at that. Lucky. It's their war machines. They had a lot of them things. Let's move forward. Oh! out of here. Yo. Goodness gracious. Yeah. Somebody's in here. I just got summoned again. Puked again. I gotta get out of here. Oh, look. Luckily, I already know where to go. There's somebody here with me. These creatures. Oh. That serpent creature still flying around. With him so I can get some of this power. So them creatures would intake the magic carpets. Now this guy here, he seems really new. His robe is not that long, but it's, well, this is decorative, but it is just below mine's. Thank you, give me some mana. Why they do that? You go about your business, Mr. Serpent thing. Look at that thing. Where's this guy at? See, now I don't have to wait for this dude. Look, he didn't have to wait for me. Two different sides. Oh, he found one. Glad I looked over there when I did. I didn't even know that one was there, surprisingly. When we're next to each other, it increases our beam as well. You gotta see. I'm flying. I'm out of here. Beam of light kept them away from here. It's nice. Tell me another story, grandfather.
A lot of people died because of that war. The city was in ruins.
Now it's covered with sand again.
The grave sites.
That looks like my character. So it seems like somehow another version of those people ascended from heaven again. That's which is us basically, and we're learning of what happened about what our instances did. So maybe we can learn a different way. We'll see. It's nice meeting you, buddy. Audi 5000. My long old scarf. I'm trying to keep it this long.
There is a way you can lose your scarf. That's, if one of those creatures grab you up like it did those, other talisman in the carpet, it'd take away your scarf.
Well, at least not the whole thing, a good portion of it, though. That board looked like it just told the beginning of my story. Since that light was illuminated down here, I'm able to float and glide and fly. Not a problem. Look what we found over there. Look like somebody's here with me. Telling the story of our journey so far. Where we are going. Scarf wrapped around my neck. It's gonna kill me. Now, if I remember somewhere around here, there is another one of... Oh, I think I just found it. With those markers, so I can increase the length of my scarf. Go down here and get some mana. Yeah, look at that, right there. And if you notice as well, it's kind of, I know it's increasing the scarf length, but they, I don't know what to call them. Let's just say characters, because they are specialty characters, I guess you could say, because they're all symbols in different shapes and everything like that, the ones I find, and they increase the scarf length and everything. But it seemed like I'm learning the language, as you can say, from Rosetta Stone, maybe. Words of power. There you go. Or frequencies of power. Another one up here. Well, portrait I can open up. Under the city, I battled those creatures. Yep, it's telling my story. How I braved this place. Oh, look. What's that? Look like a giant whale, and honestly, it looks like one of those creatures from earlier that was chasing me. But put in this paper for them, you know. Maybe this is what they all look like. I can ride this bad boy. There's another one. Just pulling me with it. Took the easy way. Feel like I got enough scarf to fly. Show me crossing the path. Pathways, this is nice. I guess you can call this a technology. It's pretty awesome. Grandmother, you have a story for me too? Lend me energy! He's building a spirit bomb. Journey, learning his history, meeting people along the way, getting through obstacles. Facing perilous creatures and puzzles. Now what's this? Yes, we gotta travel to the mountain. What does that mean? Grandmother, what does that mean? From a hot desert, now we go. Looks like it's cold over there. Find out what's the next part. Look at that snow. Mm-hmm.
happened? My man fell straight in the ground. Someone sitting up here. That's funny. Okay. This wind can be treacherous. Grave sites keep coming across. Oh my goodness. People died out here too. I'm looking, that's another one of those creature bodies right there.
Save it, temp 1 mile, too. Board here too. Well, as we've seen. Dang. My scarf is going, I guess, because it's cold. Giant's freezing it. So it seems like we're at the end of this journey. Like I said before, you know, we learned everything about the people. What happened to them, the technology they found, how it turned on them, because they basically turned on themselves. You know, if you think about it, it sounds like the human story. Our story, you know, normally go through. Ooh. Oh my god, no! No! That's what I get for not paying attention. I was not paying attention there. It don't look like, I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna be getting my white robe. Or if will the decoration become more distinctive on this rope after I beat it. But we will have to see. There's something's up here, I'm gonna go check it out. Like everybody made a pilgrimage to the mountain top to see the gods, maybe after everything that happened. Not too sure. No, his robe is just like mine.
He hasn't lost the scarf yet. Sometimes people will get hurt trying to follow and do what you do. Oh, shoot. Look at that. It's hard, it's just tedious.
caught looking at his character, thinking it was mine. Scarf is shorter than his now? When did I get caught?
Joystick is vibrating intensely right now. Feels like a pulse. Now it's starting to slow. As you see, character isn't doing too well. Oh, looking delusional. What's going on, buddy? You're about to be froze over. Yeah. The heartbeat. That's what I'm assuming. That's what the vibration is portraying. It's really dying. Here's the gods, huh? Snomasuru, I died. So she's passed out now. They're picking me up.
is with me still. Supposed to go. Oh yeah. like I didn't beat this before. Goodness. Having a conversation and shit. It's nice to meet you. As well as everybody else I met throughout the game. And just know that these people are not the same people you meet throughout the game. Thank you for playing Journey. It's a very nice story. I hear these game creators, they do this a lot. The games they make, it seems like they always have a significance behind the story. You know, maybe about Buddhism or something like that, or Christianity. Something that has meaning for a better understanding. Maybe it'll help you get through life or understand life a little better. Journey. So now, if you've picked it up as well, that shooting star we saw earlier, flying over the area we were exploring, assuming this was somebody that completed the game. Unlike the shooting star that exploded that marker, the special marker that gave me increased flight capability with my scarf. Started. Companions met along the way. Who was the last person I was with? Was it that one? War song. Start a new journey or stop, but I'm gonna see if my robe has changed. I don't know if I found everything. But let's see. I'm looking for white. Oh. I didn't. And it's still the same design I believe I had earlier. It doesn't look like it changed. So there's something I'm missing. But I guess that's for another video. Thank you everyone for joining me on this journey. You got that? Take care. This is Braxis King, and have a great day.